All right, here we are for another episode.
Made you a warrior for a reason. It's your calling.
You're winning.
He's down. Finish him.
There is a new road ahead, the only one that makes any sense. Every gate you open into darkness brings another challenge.
so weak. They can see you're weak.
Quickly get up! She can still do it. Watch out!
Stronger than you.
Finish this!
now.
However you come to the gold-covered bridge that leads to Hell, you may find it guarded by a giantess. She will ask your name. She will ask your lineage. She will ask your business. The Northmen tell of the warrior woman Brynhild, who leapt into fire and rode to Hell to join her slain love Sigurd. However you come to the gold-covered bridge that leads to Hell, you may find it guarded by a giantess. She will ask your name. She will ask your lineage. She will ask your business. The Northmen tell of the warrior woman Brynhild, who leapt into fire and rode to Hell to join her slain love Sigurd, and is challenged by the giantess.
The journey to Helheim is never a straight one. Each must find their own path. Align yourself to its secrets, and you will find yours.
Hela possesses large dwelling places in Helheim. Tall are her walls, high are her gates. The name of her dish is hunger. Her knife is famine. On her threshold all will stumble. Her bed is called sickbed, and her bed hangings are called flames of a funeral pyre. They say she is easy to recognize, half black and half the color of flesh, and her face menacing and grim.
Of the darkness. It's coming. This is your moment.
I'm sorry. I can't watch this.
What are you doing? You're showing weakness. You're not a warrior. You're a disgrace. The gods will punish you for this. Pick up the sword. Pick it up. Fight the darkness. Fight it. Get up. Get up. Get up and fight.
Stormy seas and lost souls. She's dreamt of this before. They say dreams are visions of our memories, thoughts, and fears, as seen by our inner eye. But what if each one of us is always dreaming, even when awake, and we only see what our inner eye creates for us? Is this what hell is? A world shaped by Senua's nightmares. Maybe that's why people feared seeing the world through her eyes. Because if you believe that Senua's reality is twisted, you must accept that yours might be too.
You failed the gods. You're pathetic. Rotten. Cursed. What were you thinking? Did you really think you could win? How stupid can you be?
So stupid.
Everyone hates her. She's cursed.
The shadow hates.
Look at you. A warrior. Worthless. Weak. Pathetic. Go on. Feel sorry for yourself, because there's no one left to do that for you. Take it. If you're too much of a coward to fight, then end the suffering. broken and lost. Just do like it. Your Go sword.
On, come on. There.
Why go on? When you give everything and face that which torments you, only to find that it is worse than you could have imagined. Why go on? Is it really so weak to ask this? Or are we just so afraid of the honest answer that we do not dare pose the question? Sometimes the answer lies in a memory, a feeling, a song. Before she first met him, she was not in a good place. Just a teenager, but not like the others. Barely functioning, she rarely left the house. Her father, Zinbel, made sure of that. Only occasionally did she venture out on her own, collecting firewood and herbs. Errands out in the Orkney Plains. That was her world. Like this one. Barren. And lonely.
He's going to get his son. Where's he gone? He's got something to tell the rest. Unless you're here.
Already disappeared.
Nothing lives here, not even you. It's in your mind. You think you can see it, but it's in your mind.
There's the tree.
There he was.
Where is he?
The lone figure of a boy.
He's there, under the tree.
Swordplay under the shade of a tree. She remembers the first time she saw him.
He's there, under the tree.
Her young eyes moved as if dancing. And the world danced with him. The gloom lifted. And for the first time in years, she felt a ray of hope.
The Northmen tell of a great hero. His name is Sigmund. His father's hall was built around a great tree, and one day, Odin comes and thrusts a sword into the tree, a gift to whomever can release it. Many try, but the sword only comes out at Sigmund's touch. His brother-in-law, King Siggeir, wants it, but Sigmund refuses him, so King Siggeir plots revenge. He invites Sigmund and his brothers to a feast, but when they arrive, they are met with an army, not a warm welcome. King Siggeir captures Sigmund and his brothers, steals his coveted sword, and readies them for execution.
He so effortlessly caught the world in bliss. If only she could do the same. See the world through eyes anew and dance with it just like he does. Thank you.
What's your name?
Senua.
I haven't seen you before.
I'm not... I don't leave home much.
Oh. Zeno's daughter.
I have to go.
Wait. Who taught you to fight like that?
No one.
No one?
Well, I watched you, and...
You learnt all of that from watching me? You should become a warrior, you know.
Me?
I'm Dillian. I'm here for the warrior trials. Come and watch. And bring your sword.
You can't put it into words. That moment when you look into the eyes of the one who's supposed to reassure you, make you feel safe. It only takes an instant. Fear swallows you before you have a chance to make sense of it. And darkness becomes a part of who you are.
You killed him.
But her world changed the day the Northmen took him from her. Senua knows that there's no going back to how things were. That there's nothing to go back to at all.
Stay still, stay quiet, hide, don't tell her.
Their gods can see into your mind. They will use this power to destroy you.
They won't stop me. I can still feel him.
Whatever's left of him, they will never let him go.
I'm not gonna let him rot here!
You're the one rotting here.
Leave me alone.
You will die here.
No.
And all your suffering will have been for nothing.
Shut up!
Name. is Gramr. It was forged by the god of all Northmen, Odin, and gifted to Sigmund, a great warrior.
I need this sword. It's important. Can you help me?
The sword appears whole, but it is an illusion. It shattered into shards long ago. It is said a great warrior can reforge Gramr by answering the trials of Odin, one for each shard. The roots of the Tree of Death will take you to new lands where you will face the trials.
Go to the shards. Go to the shard.
Go to the shards.
What's the shard? Find it.
It's the metal runestones.
It's in front of you. Find it. The metal. The runes.
You need that sword.
Go to the shard.
Find the shards. Where is it?
Find it. There it is.
Focus.
A king in the north forced the dwarves to make a sword that would never fail and never rust, and that would slice through iron and stone and bring victory to its bearer. But the angry dwarves cursed it. It would be the death of a man every time it was drawn, and it would be the death of the king. Let me tell you about the sword Tyrfing.
I don't recognize this place.
Where are we? Where is she?
It feels wrong.
Where are we now? Burial mound. So strange that we go to such lengths to bury death. Something so very ordinary. Inevitable. It's as if we conspire to hide death. Because we have no answer for it. But when it comes and forces itself onto our friends or loved ones, then comes the reckoning.
Senua, you remind me of a story that the Northmen tell about a young woman warrior. Her name is Hervor, the daughter of a berserker, born after he was killed. She's a wild, willful child who teaches herself to fight with weapons. When she learns where her father is buried, her only desire is to reclaim the treasure buried with him, but above all, the sword, Tyrfing.
I'm here for the trials, like when we first met, remember?
Where's he gone?
How did you let him go again?
You let him leave.
He disappeared again.
How could you?
Find him. You have to find him.
This is your mission. Find him.
You have to use everything you have
and find him. Get him back.
There he is.
Dillian.
There he is.
Finally.
You found him. What's wrong? What happened? Can you hear me? Just wait there. I'll find you.
What's wrong with you? Can't you find him? Go to him. What's happened to him?
I'll find him.
What was that? Did you hear that?
Nothing.
Was that voices?
Is that his voice or the voice of the dead?
Not Dillian.
Dillian's calling to you. Can
Where
you hear
is he?
Him?
Where is he?
He sounds like he's getting further away.
Have you lost him?
You're going.
You lost, and have you lost him?
Don't touch the walls.
You don't know what they point to.
Turn back.
She has to keep going.
It's not safe here.
She has to keep going.
If you go down there, no one can save you.
It's too scary.
Hervor disguises herself as a man to join a band of warriors, and soon becomes their leader. When they come to the island where her father is buried, her men do not want to go ashore. They say that evil haunts the island, and that it is a worse place by day than other places are by night. Fearless, she lands alone. There are many grave mounds, and all of them have ghostly flames burning over them. She comes to the grave mound of her father after passing through these ghostly fires as though they were mist. The flames I passed through were real enough. Damn the Northmen to hell.
What's happening?
It's not him, it can't be.
What's that sound? The voice is changing.
What? That's not Dillian.
That doesn't sound like Dillian.
It sounds like something more dangerous.
Something is here. Something is in the labyrinth with you.
Something evil.
Within the burial mine, Hervor calls on her father to wake from death and bring her his sword. She says that it is not seemly for the dead in their grave mounds to bear valuable weapons. Her father answers with words of warning.
You go to your doom. Baleful runes surround you. You have gone mad. You have lost your mind. Your thoughts are confused. It is dangerous to wake the dead.
Like I said, she reminds me of you.
It's not Dillian. Dillian wants me to face my fears. Father? I'm leaving. I've decided. I think it will be good for me.
It's the darkness. It's speaking through.
No, Dad, it's me. I think I can beat it. In my own way.
I can see the darkness in your eyes, child.
I met a boy.
Boy?
The chief and son.
No.
He said he could help me.
It's a trick.
He said I could be normal.
Normal?
Yes.
No boy is going to save you. No one can. When they see the rot growing inside you, they will turn their back on you. The gods can only fix you through my hand. You're going nowhere.
No.
You will not defy the gods. Come, child, take my hand. Come, Senua.
No! I am leaving!
You cannot escape the darkness. Your curse will make everyone suffer. You will have blood on your hands!
Say that their all-father, Odin, gave his eye in exchange for a drink from Mimir's well, the Well of Wisdom. In blindness there can be wisdom. Only by giving can you receive in return. For this reason, I give my life and pass on my stories of the Northmen to you, Senua.
Can you hear me?
Dillian.
I'm right here. Can't you see me?
No. Help me.
Breathe slow.
It's the darkness.
Stay still. Empty your thoughts. Tell me what you feel.
A breeze.
Good. Then there is a way out.
I can't tell where it comes from.
Yes, you can.
others. The voices, they've gone.
I'm still here.
It's so quiet. So dark.
It's okay. Listen to your own breath. Feel it rise and fall. Good. Be aware of everything you hear and feel. Let your senses guide you.
I think I'm somewhere else now. But the breeze has gone.
Use all of your senses. Let the world speak to you. What do you hear?
I hear water.
Go to it.
Thank you. reach the water.
Good. That's your way out. Follow me downstream.
I'm so sorry. I thought I left this all behind.
Don't be sorry. It's not your fault.
He was right. It's inside of me. It won't let me go.
Senua. My father. He taught me the hardest battles are fought in the mind, not the sword. You're no coward. Prove that to me in the warrior trials. This is just another battle. You can beat it.
This isn't your battle. You don't have to help me.
I want to. Besides, you are going to be a great warrior one day. We need people like you.
Okay. I'll do my best. There's a house. I don't know what's inside.
Don't be afraid.
Not following me.
Leave it behind and keep moving forwards.
I think I'm in a house. It stinks. Of death.
The darkness is testing you. But you are in control.
There's a well.
Don't turn back. You're getting close.
Delia.
Yes, I can see you too.
She could spend hours, days even, trapped within herself in the dark.
You see me?
Your eyes were open, but you were gone.
And when it finally let her go, she could be anywhere, with no memory of how she got there.
When it comes for me, I have no power over it.
But here, for the first time, someone was there to help.
But I heard your voice. You brought me back.
You found your own way back. All you needed was a little help. A little hope.
I think I'm going to leave this one here. After an hour and a half, you probably might be getting a little bored. Or may just not have the time to watch it all.